My name is Michela Arnaboldi. I work with Professor Azzone, Giovanni, you saw yesterday, and we are tackling together the perspective of decision making from profit company. So maybe it's not the better issues to be tackled after the lunch, and especially the first part, which is a bit technical, but we will try to survive. First of all, a survey. Who has a management background? Just raise your hand. Good, so we have an imbalance. So we have an imbalance. Who is from Turin, Politecnico di Torino? Who is from Politecnico di Milano? And the rest? Okay. Now, the very last, because I don't see very well everyone. Is there anyone who has done management control system? What? Hello. Did you pass my exam? Great. Okay. Don't ask her about me, please. Okay? Other, you are the only one. No other from management control system. Good. So, stand up. Stand up. Okay. Actually, please. She is a brave girl because she did with me management control system. She did with me another exam, so she's very brave. Now, what we are going to do today? This is the agenda. First of all, we tackle which is the objective of a profit company. So remember, we tackle profit company. With Bruno, you tackle the public sphere. We tackle a bit more the profit side, although I think complex decision making is public and private. We will see, as Giovanni said, how can we define alternatives for profit company. Then, very, very important, very, very boring, I know, how we evaluate the impacts. And finally, we will see tomorrow morning in the very final part of the lesson, what is a decision maker and which are the motivational issues related to decision makers, because we are never alone. Maybe in your individual decision, you are alone. Where do you come from?
I'm from Egypt.
So I think last year, 2 years ago, you have been across a decision-making process where I'm going to study for my Master of Science. And which field are you in now?
I'm architecture.
Architecture. Good. So you would love, I'm sure. And she did a decision-making process, as you did, in choosing your Master of Science. In this decision-making process, you think to be alone, but you are not, because maybe you have a boy or a girlfriend, you have parents, if you want to move, you have also financial constraints, you need to evaluate your financial situation, and so on. So it's very, very difficult that in every type of decision you are alone, especially if you are in an organization, public or private, you are never alone. So this is a very important process. And with Bruno, you have tackled different strategies to convince other actors of your idea or just to face financial constraints and so on. We will tackle this issue inside the company. So not outside, but inside. First of all, we'll look at some colors and so on. Learning challenge is my goal, my teaching goal, is the question that you should be able to answer after this lesson. Tonight we will do an exam just to test if you have learned. I'm joking. you have this. Then you see key terms, because I'm sure that you cannot remember everything we are saying today and tomorrow. But there are key terms that are important you remember. And when in the future you will face decision and so on, you remember this term, you go back on the slides, on the references, on some books, and you know where you are, at least. And this is very important, because when we talk about decision making, we will talk about measurement, and we will talk about numbers. And you are very good at being in Politecnico, Milano, or Turin. And with numbers, we can convince people. But if we are not able to read and understand the number, very likely someone else will decide for you. And you say, OK, it sounds to be a very good decision. It's financially supported. So you, in the future, you will not maybe be required to decide or to provide the numbers for decision making. But in every type of organization you will work, there will be decision, and decisions are always taken on measures. So you need to be able to read the measure, just to avoid that other people promote their ideas against yours, or maybe wrong idea for your organization. When you see this cloud, is your moment. This is just to keep you awake and not and to allow me to have a brief. First of all, first challenges. Which is the objective? You don't need to say anything. Which is the objective of a profit company in decision making, but we'll say in every moment. How can we measure this objective? So which is the goal of a profit company? Raise your hands. Because otherwise, people in the first rows are always very unlikely. So I like also to see the voices, to hear the voices of people in the back. So any ideas? Which is the goal of a profit company?
Make profits.
Thank you. So you save someone in the back. Profit. This is not a ball, a pumpkin. I search for a ball, but I don't have. Profit. Now, easy, because I ask this question to the mass. Who agrees with this? The goal of the company is profit. Raise your hands. Good. If this is an exam, you would be out. Okay. Other ideas?
Create value okay. For the company.
Good. Very good. This is the right answer. Create value. A bit more refined. We need an adjective in front of value. Shareholder value. More generally, we say economic value. But what you said is correct, because in profit company, we provide, we generate, we want to create value for our shareholder. And now we see what does it mean and who are shareholders. What is a company? A company is a box. I was going to write on this. Is a box in which we have people. Suppose we decide to create a new business. Do you have some idea for a new business?
Me?
Yeah.
No, absolutely. Do I look like I have an idea?
You are Italian.
Yeah.
Which is your field?
Mechanical engineering.
Mechanic. So you should have plenty of ideas from your field. Is there anyone who has an idea for a new business, and maybe when you finish the Master of Science, you start a new business and so on? When I pass, everyone start writing. Okay, this way. So you have an idea? No. A company. Suppose that we have an idea, a very, very simple idea. We are in Belgirate, and there are some pubs, some shops, but not so many. And so we decide that it's very warm in these days. And so we want to sell lemonade outside. So we just buy some lemons. And I pick you, which is your field.
Architecture,
so you are very good in doing lemonades, I'm sure. And why do you laugh? And we go outside. I had the idea, so I'm the boss, and you just squeeze the lemons. You squeeze the lemons, and we go outside, and we sell lemonade. And we found our company. Is Michela, what's your name?
Andrea.
Michela and Andrea Company. And we'll say Michela and Andrea, SPA, if we are in Italy, which is the label for a specific type of company, or if we are in the US, we will say Inc., I-N-C. These are juridical form for companies. A company can be me and Andrea, just doing lemon juice. Going outside, but we don't, differently from non-profit sector, why do we go outside with our lemonade? To sell the lemon juice and to get money from people outside. So we are selling lemonade. So a company is an organization made by people, technological resources, and money, because just with a very, very tiny idea as the lemonade. What do we need? Lemons.
Cups.
Squeezer. Sorry? Architects. We, maybe, we need maybe a table. We can ask architects, but we need a table just to put glasses, bottles, and so on. Okay, where do we take this? We need to go to a shop, buy lemons. So, what do we need for doing these things?
Money.
Maybe not so much money. Say, I can put 50 euros, so what can you put? Oh, good. Okay. Very good. Just because I'm the teacher. Where are you from? Turin or Milan?
Torino.
Okay, so you will never have me as teacher in Milan. Oh, you never know. Okay. So, what we put, Andrea and I, is capital, money. Not so much. 50 euros of capital. 50 and 50. This is our capital that we put in our company, C. And we are shareholders. Michela and Andrea. Shareholders are people, individuals, or sometimes other companies who own the shares, which are divisions, bits of your company, and which belongs rights in the money that you generate. We started our company, so we are just me and you. And there are only two shareholders. What's your name?
Betta.
Suppose that our business is doing very well. So we enlarge, not only in Belgirate, but in Arona, and I don't know the names of the other villages. And so Betta say, good. I don't like squeezing the lemon. I prefer Andrea does. And I don't like managing a company. I prefer Michela does. But I like this activity. I think is profitable. And I want the money from this activity. So what she can do is entering the company, providing new capital, and she will benefit from the cash that we generate from our activity. We add a new shareholder. And we are in three. What changes is that when we generate our money, suppose from our activity we generate this year 200 euros. With these 200 euros, we can just say, okay, we give this money to the three shareholders. And suppose that we have put 50, 50, 50. How would you divide the 200 that you have generated? In three equal parts, okay? Make the calculation. In this way, we have funded a new activity. We have generated money from this activity, and when we generate the money, we provide dividends. Have you ever heard about these words? Yeah. There is a moment during the year which is very, very much liked by shareholder, which is January, February. It's the moment in which company just hands out dividends to the shareholder. And this is the money which is returning. So, what do you think? Betta put 50 and she gained 63, nearly. Is it good business in 1 year? Yeah, it is. It is. I put 50 and I gain 63. If you make the ratio and if you find out the interest that you gain on this money, you find a good number. How much?
More or less 30%.
30%. How much can you gain in terms of percentage if you invest your money in state government security? Do you have an idea? Three. Gross. And the net is even lower. So it's a good business. But what happened? When we generate 200 and me and Andrea like very much working together. Do you? Okay. And we want to continue to do our activity. And so the table is not satisfactory, and the glasses are not satisfactory, because maybe we want to enlarge our activity. So we don't want to provide these 200 entirely to the stakeholders, to the shareholder, but we want to invest part of this money in our activity. The capital and part of what we have generated during the year can be invested initially for buying the table, for buying the lemons and so on, but also after the first year, we can keep aside part of our money to reinvest in something new. For example, buying a better furniture. And in doing this, we make investment. When I put the T, it means a time reference. So T can be year zero, T can be 1, it means year 1. Year 0 is always the year in which we are. So if I say year 0 now, which year I'm referring to? 2012. Good. Violet shirt. Where do you come from? Yeah. Are you from management?
No, mechanical.
Mechanical. Oh, two. So we invest in our activities, and is always lemonade. And we generate, very important, CF. This is something that you should remember forever. CF stands for cash flow. The goal of a company, as we said, is the creation of economic value, not profit. We will see the difference. The basis of the economic value is this: the generation of cash, money. Not only in 1 year, but forever. Because when you establish a company, your intention is to survive forever. And you write this in your statute. It's mandatory. You don't found, establish a company just to close in 2 years. You write in the statute that your mission is selling lemonades and doing lemonades, and you will survive forever. So your obligation towards your shareholder is to survive and to make the best use of the money to generate money, which is not so easy, because you need to balance how much money do I provide to our shareholder and yourself, if you own the company, and how much money do I reinvest in our activity. This is a tricky balance in our company. When we make our decision, our objective function is that, the economic value. What you have seen with Bruno is valid also for profit company, unfortunately, because for an easy business like producing, generating lemonades and so on, it can be easy. But for other business, we need to take into account not only our shareholder, the ones who provide capital and who want money from us, but also other stakeholders. So you see the two names: shareholders, stakeholder. Shareholders own a piece of paper which say that you have rights in the money that a company generates. Stakeholder have interest in a company. And for example, if you are Fiat, do you know Fiat? If you are non-Italian, do you know? Is the main automotive company in Italy. And who other can be interested in Fiat further to the shareholder? You say something with the pink? Pink is. Yeah, you. You. Yeah. No. Just. Okay, guess. Who can have interest in Fiat further to the shareholder?
Farther than the shareholder.
Yeah.
Italian government.
Italian government. Why? When another stakeholder. Stay there. Why?
Because it creates jobs.
You see, he creates a job.
Unions.
Unions. Oh. Yeah, these are the pain of every profit company. But don't say it to Elsa Fornero. He knows very, she knows very well. You? Yeah, and this can be a problem even for me and Andrea. Why?
Because you need a Fiat car.
part to drive your lemons.
No, in doing our business, he said, other company doing similar businesses. If we sell lemonades outside Villa Carlotta, are there other company that can be not so happy about us?
Yeah, the closest bar here.
Yeah, the bars, even Villa Carlotta, because we sell lemonade outside and so people can do not entry. So even with a very tiny activity, we can disturb other people. And so there are a lot of stakeholders which are interested in us. And we have government and local authorities. We have our clients, of course. We have our employees, because if you decide to close down a company, this is a problem for your employees. And also the environment. Do you have example of company who created a problem to the environment in recent years? Costa Crociere, very, very recent. Others, BP, British Petroleum. And there are many other cases which affected, maybe not significantly as these two companies, the environment every day. So the environment is and has become a very important stakeholder. Then in the very top, you see another important stakeholder, banks. Why, in your opinion?
Loans.
Sorry? Loans. Yes, because suppose we want to enlarge again our activity, Andrea and myself. Beta provided our money. Unfortunately, we don't find any other person who is ready to put money in our activity. But we have an idea to enlarge. In which way?
Building lemon bars and finding someone who can squeeze lemons.
So, okay, it's good. He's fed up of squeezing lemon and he wants someone so we can have a building and so on. We need much more money. What we can do is to knock at the door of banks and say, okay, we have this idea and we want money. So we have a loan, we hope to have a loan from banks. As you, as individual. So company can go to banks asking loans. And when you go to banks asking for loans, you need to convince them. And how do you convince banks that your idea are good?
Business plan.
Business plan based on what?
On our production.
Numbers, always. Always numbers. Unfortunately, I know that some of you hates financial statements, these kind of things, but be ready that sooner or later you will need to deal with these things. Because for doing something we need money. And so you need to convince people that your idea is good and you need to provide numbers for convincing people. So we have this stakeholder. And these stakeholders, apart from banks, which provide loans and then want the money back, all the other usually do not provide money, but they have interest. For all these people, also when they do not provide money, what is very important is to see and to look at the economic value. Now, we have seen that the economic value is different from profit, but we need to understand, and I apologize for the next slide, what is the economic value. The economic value is a function, is the only formula that we will see in 2 days. The economic value is just the sum of the cash that we can generate in different years. Suppose we are in 2000, always the same, in 2012. And we generate from our activity 200 cash flow. 2013, we generate 500. 214. 1,000. This is our starting business plan, because these are the cash flow that we generate, cash, money. 2015, 5,000. Great. Okay?
And how are you creating these numbers? Because, okay, maybe from 2012, 2013, we know that it will be more or less double 25, but then in 1 year it will...
Yeah, because Andrea had the idea to build a bar and to enlarge our business. So we provide in 2013 money to buy the bar, and in 2014 we generate revenues. And so we sell more lemonades. But you tackle an important point. We are in 2012, and we are predicting what will happen in 2014. We are making what we call forecasts. We just forecast. We predict. And when you ask money to the banks, but also to the shareholder, you need to convince them of your plans. But suppose that I give you this business plan. This is the picture of the cash flow. If we make the sum is 5, 6, 6.5, 6, and 700. Suppose I want the money only from one person, from one shareholder, and I ask to, are there environmental engineers? Good, brave guy. Okay, this is my business. Let's see, do you give me 1,000 euros if I give you now, if I give you back 1,000 euros in 2014?
Would I give you 1,000 euros?
Yeah, it's just no, really.
No.
Why?
If you give me 2,000.
He said no, so. Record that these students will not provide to me 1,000 euros.
Give me back 2,000, I think.
2,000. How did you calculate your 2,000?
I want to earn some money, so if I invest, I expect something in return.
This is, see, this can sound to a very simple reasoning strange, because I ask you 1,000 and I give you back 1,000. Why don't you accept? Because you are waiting 2 years and money has a cost. First of all, why money has a cost? The first idea that comes to your mind. Inflation, very good. Because with these 1,000 euros in 1,000 euros today, we will buy less things in 2014. Just because the prices of things tend to increase. Not only houses, but also vegetables and so on. If you live in Italy, also if you are non-Italian, you are experiencing this situation. Because we had, at the end of last year, an increase in a tax, which is called VAT, IVA in Italian. And we had an increase of 1%. This increase, this VAT, is applied to everything, nearly everything which is on the business. With this increase, you could have seen an increase in the cost of vegetables, in the cost of food especially. And this has created inflation. So for sure, your answer is correct. If you give me 1,000 in 2012, unless we are very close, you are, I don't know, I am your sister and so on, so you are ready to do this. But otherwise, you don't wait 2 years to have back 1,000 because you have inflation. Other reasons?
The risk that you fail.
The risk that you fail. Refined.
Which, I don't know.
Which is your field?
Automation Turin.
Automation. Turin or Milan?
Milan.
Milan. This is a good dance.
In 2013, just at a glance, I mean, after 2 years, perhaps you gave me some money every month, just the interest. But I'm not sure that, for example, meanwhile, you pay. And so I want some money back that compensates the risk to be paid. And so I don't have all the money back.
Yeah, good. So we have one factor. First of all, inflation. Second, I can be very convincing, but I'm a business company, a profit company, and in every type of business, there is an inbound risk. Always. We have differences, and we will see in different type of companies. So we have higher risky business, and we have less riskier business. But we always have a risk in profit company. So your answer is correct. There is something more that we quote at the very beginning. We have inflation, we have a risk, but we have also the opportunity to invest our 1,000 euros in government bonds. Doing this, we have what is called a risk-free rate. If you put your money in government securities bonds, you will have a very, very low interest rate, which is net nearly 2% if you are lucky, but is safe. Not in Greece in this moment, it's dangerous. Italy seems to have recovered, so it's safer, and I bought, so I hope. But this is not for some country. Do you remember a country? You are young, but maybe you should remember. Very good. Okay. Argentina is a country which had some problem. Greece is nearly there. Italy was nearly there before Christmas. Now we are in a safer situation. So we have these three elements. With these three elements, we are not ready to put 1,000 and to have 1,000 in 2014. Because at least we can invest our money here. Or at least, suppose we do not want to invest, we have the inflation. And so we want to pay the bread and to buy the bread and so on. So we cannot afford this exchange. This is very important because if you look at our cash flow, if I tell you that we will gain 5,000 euros in 2015, we need to take into account that the value in 2012 of these 5,000 euros will be lower or higher?
Lower,
very good. How much lower?
And to understand how much lower, we use this formula. And in particular, the denominator. This formula and the denominator is the actualization of the cash flow. Suppose we have an interest summing the risk-free rate, the inflation, and the risk of the company, an interest of, we call K, then we will see what does it mean, of 2%, 5%. If I invest 200, and if I want to understand which is the money that I can gain with this 500, what you do is 200, can you see? From the back. Our K is 5%. We take an easy number. Our capital in 2012 is 1,000 euros. If I invest my 1,000 euros in a company which has average as an interest rate of 5%, which is the capital that you expect in 2013? 1,050, yeah, sorry. Which is the calculation? 1,000 times? Okay, good. Did you get this point? We have an interest of 5%. It's like if you invest the money in the bank, you put 1,000, the interest is 5%, what you generate is 150. Suppose we want to reinvest our money. 2014. What we do is 1,050 times what? 1.005. Okay? If we go back, we can say also 1,000 times 1 plus 0.5. Is this correct?
Yes.
Good. Can we write this in this way? 1 plus 0.05 raised 2. Okay? If we use variables instead that numbers, we find that the value at year 2, because this is year 1, this is year 2. The value at year 2 is equal to the value at year 0 times 1 plus K, our interest, raised 2. This is a formula that we can use not only for the second year, but for the third, for the fourth, and we can generalize and say that if we want to calculate how much money we will have with the interest rate of 5% in a generic year N, we can write the initial capital times 1 plus K raised N. Did you get this point? This formula is just the reverse of the one that you see here. If you put T instead of N, if I want to understand the value in this moment, year 2012, of money that I will generate in a generic year T, what I need to do is the reverse. The value at year zero is the value at year T divided by 1 plus k raised t. This formula, as I said, is the one that we use here. Now we go in the economic meaning of this formula, and it's called actualization. This formula, which help us in understanding how much money we will gain at a specific interest, is called compounding. You don't need to learn, but in the future, I'm sure, also if you buy a car or a house, it's better you understand how to calculate this kind of interest swaps and so on. So, just to recap, we want first to understand which is the goal of a profit company. Which is the goal of a profit company? Which is the goal of a profit company? To generate the economic value, which is translated making money for the long run. Just very simply, a company wants to make money, a profit company, not all the company. We have also non-profit company, but profit company want to make money for the long run. The measure that we use if we are able to generate money in the long run is the economic value. What you see on the slides is the numerical translation of our capability to generate money. Generate money means that from zero to when? From zero to when? Infinite. We want to generate
Cash flow.
Cash, very good. Which is your field?
Management.
We want to generate cash. So, if we generate cash in different year, what we do is that we sum. Very simply. The only problem is that in different years we have different values. And so 1,000 today is different from having 1,000 in 2020. How can we solve this problem? What's your name?
Federica.
Who are not from management. What did you say?
The easy question.
But you can help.
Bravo!
Okay, we have a problem. We want to compare different cash flow generated in different years. How can we solve? You. What's your name?
Veronica.
Women are always better than men, so.
I think error factor that consider the inflation risk-free and risk gain.
What's your field?
Architecture.
So, Veronica. Veronica answered correctly. She said, if we have different cash flow in different years, what we can do to solve the problem that we have inflation and so on? Actualization. Very good. So this formula, which seems to be very complicated, is not, because you need to focalize every single term. What do we have in the left side? a label which is NPV, which stands for net present value. It's the same to say economic value. Net present value, economic value are the same. On the other side, we have a symbol. Given that you are all from a Politecnico, you should know this symbol. What does it mean? Sum. And you know what means from zero to this symbol? Infinite. So it means that we don't stop in 2014, but we continue to the infinite. Okay? The most difficult part. What do we have inside the series, the sum? At the numerator, what do we have? You. I'm sorry, I go always for girls. I will go also for men. What's your name?
Julia.
Julia.
We have the difference between the cash flow and the investment.
Okay, are you from management?
Yes.
Good. You seem to be very convincing, sir. We have CF cash flow minus, we take away the money that we put in our activity. For me and Andrea, what is an investment, for example? Sorry?
The new squeezer.
And at the denominator, we have the actualization formula. So this very complicated formula is very simple if it is analyzed term by term. This is just the acronym net present value, which is the reference for every type of profit company. When you say which is the goal of a company is the generation, let's say, the maximization of net present value, which is equal to the sum of the net cash flow taking away the investment actualized. Now we look at the different terms very quickly because we have already tackled the different terms. You see there at the top the formula because I'm sure that people from management knows this formula very well, but maybe you don't, so it's there. At the end of the lesson, I will make a test. So I will call someone here to write the net present value formula. I will pass tonight at dinner and asking you if you remember the formula. So be prepared. This is our formula. The first term at the top, cash flow. What is a cash flow? Because we have continued to talk about cash, cash, cash. Just with our intuition, cash is money. But when we talk about, excuse me, if you have problem, raise your hands. Otherwise, do you have problems? Okay. Cash flow is money, but how do we generate this money? When we make a decision, a business, we generate money from selling our products. Or if we don't sell products like these microphones, we can provide a service. Can you provide an example of a service, not a product? Taxi. They provide a service, not a product. They move people from one point to another point. This is an example of a service. Have you ever taken a taxi? Did you pay for the taxi? This is a way to generate money from taxi driver. So they provide a service to generate money. But when we have cash flows, we don't have only inflows, money coming in, but we have also outflows, which are different from investment. This is another difficult point. We have inflows because we sell our activity. But cash flow are made by inflows and outflows. Inflows as we said, can be us selling lemonades in flows. Suppose we sell lemonades for 300 euros. Our investments are, for example, the table and so on. We will say next what is investment precisely. But we have also current outflows, something that we need to buy to do our business. In our activity, you are not from management, or you are?
No, no.
Yeah. What can be a cash outflows for us? Lemons.
I have a question. So is an outflow to maintain your current business or also improve it as well?
Yeah, this is a question. Do you want to maintain your business or do you want to improve? You need always to improve. Always. It's just because improvement and innovation is the only way to maintain. It's just you cannot think to maintain a business just staying in your situation and not putting money. And a cash outflows, in our small example of the lemonade, are lemons. We need to buy lemons to do lemonade. But then we say, we have also the table. And I tell you that the table is not a cash outflow, but I will put in the investment. Why? It's always cash outflow, because if I buy the table, I need to pay money. If I buy the lemons, I need to pay money. Not from management, because they should know. Which is the difference? And why, in your opinion, lemons are put up within cash flow and instead the table is put within investment?
Because you buy the table just once at the beginning, while you buy lemons to produce lemonade, so it depends on the amount of lemonade you produce.
Yeah, the difference is that I buy the lemon and I use the lemon this year, immediately. Instead, I buy the table and I'm supposed to use the table for more than 1 year. So an investment is always money that is going out from the company, like this. But these are assets that we are going to use in the future, not only in this moment. Instead, lemons are used in this moment, in this year. Are you sure? Do we buy lemon and do we use in this year?
I hope so.
Do you have, for example, example of company which can buy material this year and use material in the future?
Wine.
Raw material. Wine.
Cups.
Yes, are not material. Cups are here. Can I buy lemon now and use the lemon in 2013? Dangerous. If I am, for example, a furniture company, and I understand that in this moment the cost of woods is very convenient. I'm producing table, chairs, and so on. Can I buy the wood now because it's very convenient? And can I use the wood in 2013? Yeah, because it's not perishable like lemons.
But if the cups were disposable, then they would be an outflow.
Good. if they are disposable, so if you use once, they go there, caps. But in this case, what happens is that you can buy more caps just because, again, your supplier say if you buy 10, you buy 1 euros per cup. If you buy 1,000, you will buy 1 cent, so you will buy more. When you do this, this becomes an investment. Always, when we use things in this moment, we say in the current activities, these are cash outflows. When we use in future moment, they go under the investment. Obviously, this is just a convention, a rule. The important thing for you is to understand what is a plus and what is a minus, what is coming in and what is going out, and when you are going to pay this money. If I buy the table now and the table cost 2,000 euros and our supplier tell us you need to pay 2,000 euros now, this is money going out immediately. So for me, this is what is important, that I need to pay. The fact that in economic rules, this goes under investment, not under cash, is just a rule. What is important is to understand when we get money and how much, and when we need to pay money and how much. Then the division between the two is just a convention, which is useful for many other reasons, but the plus and the minus is important, okay? And something which is very important, and these are the only other technical thing that we are facing today. Cash flow is different from profit. Some of you, at the very beginning, when I ask which is the goal of a profit company, which is misleading, it said profit. This is not true, we have said, because our goal is to generate cash. It's now important to see which is the difference between cash and profit. Suppose, again, me and Andrea selling lemonades. We are going outside Villa Carlotta and we sell lemon juice for 300 euros. But we had during the day some clients who asked us to pay tomorrow. So we sold lemon juice for 300, but we received money for 250. The other 50 was a favor for our new clients. They say, oh yes, we want the lemon juice, but we don't have the money in our pocket, because just we went for a run and so we don't have our money. So I will give you the money tomorrow. Which is your cash inflows for today? Suppose you don't pay the lemons and so on. 250. In a document called profit and loss account within financial statement, which is the basis for calculating profit, what is calculated is not the cash that you generate, but a term called revenue, which is the amount of profit, say, that you can generate from your selling activity. The revenue in this case is
300. Because according to the regulation, which is at the basis of the financial statement, is important not only to make an evaluation of the cash that you are able to generate, but also of your exchanges activity, selling activity. And if you say, how much lemonade were you able to sell today? What would you say to your shareholder? You would say 300, not 250.
I sold that, but I didn't get all the money.
Yeah, your answer is correct. If I make you the question, how much lemonade did you sell? You say 300, because actually you sold 300. You were able to raise only 250 of cash, but you sold 300. So your answer is correct. And this is what national and international regulation want in the financial statement, to see revenues, what you sold. And we have another document instead, which tell us how much cash you were able to raise. Why is important revenues? Because if your clients are reliable, sooner or later you will raise the remaining 50 euros. And so you will gain a further 50 euros. In our business accounts, these two faces are always important. The profit side, in which we have revenues and cost, and the cash side, in which we have money exchange. Taking away from revenues the cost, suppose the cost of the lemon, we get the profit. So the profit is very, very simple in general term, because it's the difference between revenues, 300, minus the cost. We didn't talk about cost in terms of lemons, but suppose that I tell you, for producing this lemon juice, this revenue, we needed to buy lemons for 200 lemons. 200. Okay? This is the cost of our raw material. I would put 200. The profit is the difference between revenues and cost. Which is the profit? 100. Is that clear? So this is the difference between cash and profit. If you have understood, now is your moment. Read the cost is different from outflows. Suppose that we have, I recap our numbers, we have revenues of 300 and we had a cash inflows of 250, okay? I said we bought lemons for 200. Suppose I make a complication, I say, we have found a very good supplier, and so we bought today lemons for 200, but we will pay everything in 2013. Great. We use the lemon, we buy the lemon, we have a cost. Because when you buy something, you have an agreement with someone, you have a contract, and so you generate a cost, which is the cash outflows.
Cash outflows? Zero. Good. Cash outflows is zero. Which is your profit? Profit? 100. Which is your cash? 250. Suppose we have a different situation. I tell you, I change my mind. I am your supplier. I want the money now. So you buy the lemon now, and I want the money. What do we put here? 200. Which is your profit? The same, always 100. Which is the amount of cash? 50. So, changing the paying policy towards your supplier, your cash changes, your profit doesn't change. We are in a specific year. Here we are in 2012. Yeah, we always, we are now in the part of the numerator, the cash flow and the investments. Then when you have calculated all the cash flow for different year, you need to actualize. Actually, the most, yeah. For example?
No, revenues and costs.
No, we calculate the cost.
Okay, but we have to actualize revenues and costs.
Ah, okay, I didn't catch you. Yeah, he said, do we need to actualize revenue and cost? Not for decision making, because our reference is the cash flow. Are you from management? No. In the financial statement, which are based on profit, we look only at 1 year. This is a big difference. When you open, if you are curious, I know that you have the Wi-Fi. If you are curious and you go on a company website, every kind, big company, you can download the financial statement. In the financial statement, you see this picture. This is the income statement. And you will see revenue, cost, and the profit. But what you see is always a past situation of 1 or 2 years, never a forecast of future years. This is the difference. When we make a decision, we don't work on past numbers, but on future forecasts. And we work on cash flows. Other question before the exercise? Good, you have 3 minutes. Okay, this is your moment. The solution. I'm not so cruel, so I don't ask you to come out. Everyone is ready? Good. So, two different half of a financial picture. The blue one is the profit picture. And in the profit picture, we have revenues. We are saying that we are selling for 40 million, and so we have revenues for 40. And we use and buy material for 30, for 15. So we have 15 of profit. we have a cash inflows of 30, because we receive only 30, not only 10, which are due in future period. Then we have a cash outflows just equal to the cost of material, 25. So we have a profit of 15, and we have a cash flow of 5. Which is the most important between profit and cash? For our objective function is cash, because we want to analyze the cash. In the financial statement, what do you find? We find both. Usually, common people look at this. People, shareholders, not specialists, usually look only at profit. What can be the risk if we look at a company, suppose Fiat, and we see a very high profit, and we don't look at the cash? Which can be the risk? Sorry?
The cash flow is the cash is the amount of money you have.
Excuse me, in the back.
So it can be that you receive money as profit in 2 years, but maybe you have expenses now, and so maybe if you can't pay expenses, so you have to get money from a loan, for example, so interest in the loan.
Yeah. Suppose that Fiat decide this policy. Now you can buy a Fiat 500 for, I don't know which is the cost, 8,000 euros, and you will pay the 500 in 2020. How many people do you think will buy a Fiat 500? A lot. We are in 2012, and I'm telling you that you can buy the car now, and you will pay the 500 in 2020. What happened to my profit and loss account? To the revenues? Very, very high. What happened to my cash, not only in 2012, but between 2012 and 2020? It will be zero for the Fiat 500. This is a danger, and this is why you need to look not only at profit, but at the cash flows. Because this is where you see if companies have money to improve, to invest, to innovate. A lot of companies in this moment have cash problems, because they do not generate enough cash from their activities. Banks are not so kind in this moment to provide loans, and so you can have a problem of cash. This is a problem also for big companies, because a lot of clients, also business clients, failed between 2009, 2010, and 2011. If your client fail, and if these clients need to provide money for past revenue, what happened to your cash? It's a problem. Because you were supposed to have the cash from past revenues, but your client failed. What do you say to the banks? I'm sorry, my client failed. And the bank answer, OK, it's not my business. It's your business. I want my money back. It's not a bank business. If you have a loan, they want the money back. It's not their business if your client fails. So the cash management is something very important always. But when there are economic crises, a general situation of crisis in the economy, cash management is crucial. The only problem is that sometimes we have seen that in the numerator we have two elements, cash and investments. Do you remember? If we want to maintain a certain level of cash, what we can do is to increase our source for inflows, but we have another weapon, cut investments, cut improvement, cut innovation. And this is again another problem in this moment. We don't have, as company, enough cash to do investments. Banks are not, as I said, ready in this moment to finance activity just because they have their own problems. And so we have a situation in which few, rare, very, very few companies innovate and invest money in research and innovation. And this is a problem. And this is why it's always important to look at cash, not in a year, 2012, but forever, with an infinite horizon. Because if we look at 2012 and if we don't do investment, okay, we are safe for this year. But if we do not do investment, what happens is that we don't have good products, we cannot provide good service, and so we cannot maintain our cash forever. So two things you should remember from this first part. The objective of the company is the economic value. The economic value is measured with that formula, which is the net present value. And in this formula, we have three terms which are very important. First of all, the horizon, the sum from zero to infinite. Very difficult, but you should aim for that. Second, we have cash and not profit. Third, we have the actualization, because money now is different from having money in 2012. These are the three key things that you need to remember. Sum on an infinite horizon, so not only now, but forever. Cash and actualization. If you remember these three things, you are in a good position to start to make the evaluation of an investment, of a decision. As we have said, we have not only the cash and the expenses, but we have investment. This is something very, very specific. We don't enter in detail of this. But we have two types of investment. Investment in fixed assets, this table. Fixed assets are assets, resources that we use for more than 1 year. The table, do you have other example of fixed assets? Also in your individual life?
House.
House? Car? Other? Do you have in... we have instead investments which are current, that we call operating working capital. These are, again, resources, but we use not more than once, but we use in a specific moment. For example, the lemons that we buy and we put in our warehouse. And we will use the lemon tomorrow. This is called inventories. When you buy material and then you use the material in a future moment, you are doing an operating working capital investment. What is important again is the cash generation. If I buy lemons now, today, Tuesday, that I will use on Saturday,
I'm putting my money in something that will generate money on Saturday. So I'm stacking my cash. I'm using my cash for the lemons and I cannot use my cash for something else. It's stuck, it's an investment. The difference is that is related to the current operating activity of doing lemonade. Instead, the table is used for more than 1 year. This is the difference. And this goes again at the numerator. We have seen that the actualization is made, includes a K, a letter. This K is called cost of capital. The cost of capital is made of the three things that you have said before. The cost of inflation, the cost of investing in secure, safe activity, and the specific risk of a company. If I am, for example, Enel, do you know this company? Yes. Non-Italian, do you know Enel? Yes. Enel is the main energy producer provider in Italy. 10 years ago, he was a state-owned company and they were a monopolist in Italy. The energy was provided only by Enel, just a few things, but now we are in a sort of free, not totally, free market in which we have many providers, but Enel is still the main provider of energy in Italy. But it's also a worldwide company. They have investments all over the world. Then we have a company producing semiconductor. Do you know semiconductor? Good. Semiconductor is a very specific activity because it needs a lot of research, a lot of money that you need to be invested to the research, because it's something which is not consolidated. We need to improve to have good outputs from this activity. So we have an energy provider, Enel, and we have a semiconductor company. Where would you invest your money? Semiconductor or Enel? Who would invest in Enel? Who would invest in semiconductor? All the other would not invest. This is a good decision, maybe. So we have Enel and semiconductor. We are talking about the cost of capital. If you remember, the cost of capital is a percentage. K is a percentage. Do you remember which is the amount of K in our first example? 5%. 5% of cost of capital means that this is what you as shareholder expect as an interest from your company. So if you invest in our company and the cost of capital is 5%, this means that this is the average return we had in recent year for our shareholder. So if you invest 100, you get 5 every year. Okay, is that clear? This is the cost of capital, which includes the risk of the company. We have Enel. What do you think of Enel? Is it a risky company? No. It's a utility company, it's not risky. What do you think of is K compared to the K of semiconductor? Which is higher? A or B? B, because B is risky. We have a risk premium which is higher, so the cost of capital can be 18%. You have 1,000 euros. Where do you invest?
and Enel can be 4 or 5. Where do you invest?
In Enel.
Why?
Because I would be more sure, better to have 50 than to have 180 maybe.
Yeah, always remember, this is an average. An average, which means that if you are very lucky, in 1 year you can get from this company 30%. But if you are not lucky, in that year you can gain, you can get a minus 50. So, how do you know if this is a good or bad year? Making forecasts. Looking at the context, at the economic situation, at the technological improvement of this company, and you can decide if in future years you will be in the positive side or in the negative side. When you have company with lower cost of capital, the variance around the average is lower. So you can get a year with 2, 1, a year with 5, 6, but you are around this. The risk of this company is much higher. So where do you invest depends on your risk appetite. Have you ever heard this word? It's very trendy. Risk appetite. You, if you have a very high risk appetite, I'm sure you will go for that. Because I say, I want money, I'm ready to take my risk. If you are prudent, as I am, also because I have a loan to pay to the bank, I will go for Enel. Okay? This period, and in particular 2011, was bad for every company, I think. There are very, very few companies which were able to provide dividends over the average, because we had a bad year, especially in European and US country. Different situation for Asia, because Chinese companies are doing very well. So in this company, we have a different situation. So when we have this, we need to carefully evaluate what we can do. Different companies have different cost of capital. And this is very important. If I am Enel, and if I am evaluating an investment, and I want to calculate the net present value, I will use as cost of capital 4. If I am a semiconductor company and I'm evaluating an investment and I want to calculate the net present value, I will use this, 18, in the actualization formula. What changes in your opinion? In year zero, Enel and the semiconductor with the same cash flow have no differences, because in year zero, I don't do the actualization. If I'm evaluating the cash flow in 2020, and suppose Enel and the semiconductor company both gain 1 million. If I want to know the value now of this 1 million, this 1 million would be higher in the actualization of Enel or in the actualization of the semiconductor company? Enel, because here we have an 18. So this is very important. The same numerator, the same cash flow that we have for two different companies give a different net present value, because we have different cost of capital. Now, another question. Which is, in your opinion, the safest sector in this moment? IT, no, is not a safe business. It tends to be a risky business.
Healthcare.
Sorry?
Healthcare. No, according to some statistic of European venture capital, let's say, organization, investing in agriculture, as far as I think.
Generally, the sector for the European situation, the safest is the one that we tackled before, utility. Utility, because we need water, we need energy, we need that. This is an average, because within energy company we have Enel and we have a small company doing renewable energy, which is a bit more tricky. Instead, the most riskier are semiconductor and IT, especially when they are doing not Google, but different kind of things. In the middle, we have all the other businesses, automotive, traditional sector, but these are the ranges. Since 2010, the safest sector was not utility, was another. Can you guess which? Sorry? Banks, very good. Is still now they are a bit they are very near to utility, but after the financial crisis, banks are not considered a very safe business, no, at least not the safest, okay? Now we have seen the picture of all the variables that are included in the net present value. Now, this is what we are going to see next.